Hi, I'm James from Portainer, and in this video I'm going to talk about the new features in version 2.18 of Portainer. A big focus of this release has been improving the performance of the Portainer interface, and I'll talk about some of the changes we've made to improve load times for the UI. I'll also tell you about our new MicroKates provisioning functionality, letting you spin up a kube cluster on your servers straight from Portainer. We've expanded our support for Kubernetes annotations in this release, as well as added a new services view for kube environments. For Edge users, we've improved the workflow around Edge agent deployments for standard and async devices, expanded our snapshot functionality even further, added support for a separate MTLS certificate, and added a retry policy toggle to Edge DAC deployments. I'll cover all of that in this video, and of course, I'll tell you how you can upgrade to 2.18. One of the first things you might notice in 2.18 is a snappier UI. We've made a number of changes to the Portainer interface in this version to improve load times across the board, with some specific changes around the number of notifications displayed, adding the ability to disable GPU functionality on environments where it isn't needed, and streamlining the environment API calls made throughout the app, in particular for Kubernetes environments. We'll be continuing to look for areas where we can improve performance, so look out for more of this in a future release. In the Kubernetes space, 2.18 brings the ability to provision and configure a MicroKates Kubernetes cluster directly onto fresh machines, straight from the Portainer interface. All you'll need is SSH access to the machines, and you're good to go. Provide one or more IP addresses of your servers, choose the version of MicroKates to install, and select any add-ons you require, and optionally, select a custom application template to deploy once your cluster is created. Portainer will install MicroKates, configure the cluster, and deploy the Portainer agent for you, getting you up and running on Kubernetes as painlessly as possible. In 2.18, we've expanded our support for adding Kubernetes annotations to resource types through the UI. You can now add annotations through the Portainer interface for namespaces, application deployments, config maps, and secrets, with support for services coming in a future release. In this release, we've added a new services page to Kubernetes environments, which lists the services deployed on your cluster, along with detail about each service. For example, application and namespace the service belongs to, the type of service, and any ports and IPs assigned to the service. This page replaces the port mappings tab from the applications page, and along with our work on the ingresses page in 2.16, is part of making the various objects in your Kubernetes cluster more visible when using Portainer. In the Edge arena, we've continued on from the work in 2.17 to bring Edge devices in alongside standard Edge agent deployments. In 2.18, we've split Edge agent provisioning into two types, Edge agent standard for the traditional Edge agent environment deployment, and Edge agent async for asynchronous deployments. When adding an environment, you'll be able to choose between the two options, so you can be sure you're deploying the configuration you need. In more expansion of 2.17's features, Portainer's snapshot functionality now lets you browse even more of your environment from the snapshot, including container status, volume, image, and stack listing, and the ability to stop, start, restart, and kill containers as needed. You'll also be able to see more detail, including which images and networks are in use, as well as environment variable details. Previously, when deploying Edge agents using MTLS, you were restricted to using the same TLS certificate for both the Portainer user interface and your MTLS deployment. In 2.18, you can now choose a specific set of certificates for MTLS use, separate from the one used for Portainer itself. This is particularly useful when you have separate domains for access to Portainer and for your Edge agent communications. Portainer sees the addition of a retry policy for your Edge stacks. With retry deployment enabled, Portainer will keep trying to redeploy your stack if it runs into deployment errors. This helps to avoid failed deployments when a connection to the Edge device may be unstable or unreliable. These are the big features and changes in 2.18, but there's also a ton of other changes and fixes in this release. Have a look at our release notes for the full list of changes. If you're doing a fresh install of Portainer on your environment, Business Edition users can take a look at our install guide at install.portainer.io. This will guide you through what you need to run Portainer and show you how to install it. For our community edition, you can use our documentation at docs.portainer.io. Upgrade guides for both editions are also available in our documentation, as well as instructions for upgrading from CE to BE. Thanks for watching. I hope I've been able to show you some of the new features and updates in Portainer 2.18. If you do have any questions, need help, or would like more information on anything I've talked about here, please check out our documentation, join our community support channels, or get in touch with us directly.